What is the importance of the ravens to Stalo people as well as its characteristics?
Back in the early 90s, I was initiated into the longhouse, and one of the main teachings there was to acknowledge spirit. Well, I didn't know how to acknowledge spirit, so they told me that whenever you have a meal, whatever you eat, you save one little portion of everything that's on your plate. It's the bite, breakfast, lunch, dinner, and then you have a plate of food. And then by remembering spirit, you bring that food outside and you set it on a stump or set it down by the river when you go for a swim. And then you face the east and you pray to Creator. You pray to the raven spirit. You leave that food on that stump or on that rock. And you give thanks for another day. You give thanks for your health, your well-being. You thank Creator for the food that you eat, the clothes that you wear, the shoes on your feet, the bed you sleep in, the roof over your head. You give thanks and you remember and you be thankful and you be grateful for your health, for everything, for waking up to another beautiful day. And you leave that food there and you go for your swim. And then you carry on with your day. So the raven spirit, being remembered, being fed, being acknowledged, is the key to the Stalo people, that you're one with the earth, one with all the Creator's creatures, the plants, the animals, the water, the mountains, the eagles, the ravens, everything. We're all one. We all live together in harmony. And the raven is very tricky. The raven is very spiritual. It's very elusive. It's Raven can transform, he can shapeshift, he's magic, he's a trickster. And today, you're going to run into people like that all over the place, especially in the school. So we teach about Raven, because Raven is magic. And if you got Raven on your side, then you're going to have a way better life.
What is a hospital? What is the significance to Stalo culture?
Excuse me. A house post represents a number of things. Usually, when there's a totem pole or a house post in the building, the pole represents the clan of the people who live there. It represents, I guess, the leader, the man of the house, so to speak. That's his family clan, it's his crest. Other places, like inside a building or a structure, you would put a totem pole or a raven, or it could be a welcome figure. It doesn't matter what it is, but what it represents. Like to the Salish people, to the Stalo, we have welcome figures outside our longhouses. We have welcome figures inside our homes. And to me, having a raven inside a school, it says a lot about the place, the people, the company, and all the people who are associated with the structure of the school. It's here for a reason. It's here to make all of these young spirits in here wiser, stronger, smarter. It's a tool to make everything right, make everything better. Because in the world we live in today, so much negative, there's so much evil, there's so much demons. It's pretty hard today. But you got the raven spirit on your side, you're good.
What is the role of the CRG and some of its practical uses?
That's a good question. A long time ago, all of the longhouses were built and made with cedar. Cedar can outlast any other wood. It could last for 300 years. If you got some really good old growth cedar and you looked after it by oiling it and stuff and maintaining it. By far cedar is the top of any wood in our culture, in our ways, because we use the whole tree right from the roots right up to the very top, the cedar boughs right at the top. We use the wood because it's so durable, it lasts, it has its own oils, and it'll last for till the end of time if you built it right, if you used it right. We used the cedar log for homes. We use it for building everything. The roots, those are used as well. We use them for baskets and clothing, just like the outer bark. We use that for clothes and baskets and hats and everything. Our ancestors used it for everything and anything because cedar is a gift from Creator. The Sts'ailes people are the people of the river. The people of the river are one with all of the plants, the animals, the river spirit, the cedar spirit, the Sts'ailes people spirit, and all the animals. We're all one with the earth, and that's cedar is by far right up there on top with the rest of the important things in life, like water. Water is everything, and so is cedar.
What as an artist and a carver are you most looking forward to for this project?
Well, I'm totally into what my ancestors taught me, and that was to keep your life simple. You get up in the morning, you remember spirit. You remember to eat, you remember to feed spirit. You remember spirit, spirit remembers you. You forget about spirit, chances are spirit's gonna forget about you. Your life is gonna be what you make of it. If you have spirit on your side, and you believe in here and in here, then you'll have a easygoing life. But if you're just trying to take the world on by yourself, you're gonna have a hard life. Life is all about choices. It's up to you on who you choose to follow, what you choose to believe in. You become who you follow. Whoever you hang out with, that's what you become. You have your culture, you have your beliefs, then you're going to be okay. It's all up here. Don't ever let the wrong people lead you astray.
Awesome.